Hello and welcome. Have you ever been in a situation where you decide to go to a shop and think of buying one chocolate, but you end up buying 20 chocolates? I'm sure you can relate to that experience. Something similar happened to the Britishers when they came to India. They did not come to capture territories. They came as traders, but they ended up occupying a huge number of territories. Let's learn a little bit more about this in history chapter from trade to territory. Let's get into it. Let's start with a man who was already in India, Aurangzeb. Aurangzeb was the last of the powerful Mughal. Now, as I said, powerful Mughal. He established control over a large part of the territory, what we now call as India. In 1600, East India Company acquired a charter, a permission from the ruler of England, Queen Elizabeth I, granting it sole right to trade with the East. So before the East India Company, before the Britishers arrived in India, in 1498, Vasco da Gama had already landed in India in a place called Calicut, and he took with him whole lot of stuff like spices, perfumes, precious stones, etc. So by the 17th century, India had seen a lot of countries coming to India: Portugal, Dutch and France. The problem was not about their coming. The problem was all the companies wanted to buy same things like cotton, spices, silk, because there was a lot of demand in the European market. Hence, the competition started to grow, and the only way to win that competition was to eliminate, to destroy, or to remove the rivals. Hence, there were battles being fought, so there was a lot of quarrel and fighting. This is one of the reasons they could not keep trade and politics separate from each other. It was non-separable. Now, moving on to East India Company started their trade in Bengal. I've written here EIC, just as a short form for East India Company, the Britishers. Alright? East India Company started to trade in Bengal, and they started their first English factory on the banks of river Hooghly in 1651. And the traders who worked there were called as factors. In 1696, they started to expand their area. They started to build forts. 2 years later, they bribed a Mughal official into giving zamindari rights. Right to occupy villages. So they ended up occupying 3 villages. And one of those villages was Calicutta, now which we now call as Calcutta. And still the Britishers were not satisfied. They started to persuade. They started to force Aurangzeb to issue a farmman. Now, farmman is a royal edict or a royal order to trade duty-free. If so many things were happening, you know, there would be fighting. There would be battles. That is exactly where we were going. Let's see how the East India Company, who came as traders, ended up occupying large number of territories. After the death of Aurangzeb, there were few more Nawabs. Now, they were powerful, but not as powerful as Aurangzeb. Murshid Ali Khan was followed by Aliwardi Khan and then Siraj Daula. They refused to grant concession and they said, no, you want to trade? You trade, but pay our taxes. They denied their right to mint coins, basically making of new coins. They stopped it. No more extending of forts. All this was leading to a first battle, the Battle of Plassey. Now, I know you are excited to learn a little bit more about that, but wait, we'll do that in the next class. The reason is very simple. Let's make the foundation very strong. So I want you to go back and watch that video again. You'll be very sure of what happened before the Battle of Plassey. If you found this class helpful, hit that like button so I know that it's helping you. And also subscribe to the channel to get all my classes. Take care. Thank you very much.